Right, well, good evening everyone, and welcome to further coverage of the 2019 SMPT UK Open. We are now down to the semi-final stage in the cup event and the final of the plate and the shield. We're going to concentrate on the cup action. I will bring you updates for the other matches though. So in the shield final, it's Wendy Ford against Michael Dory, and in the plate final, Benny Sjögren of Sweden against Don McNamara from Ireland. And then in the main event, your first semi-final, Jonas Hager from Sweden, who put out Steve Proctor, Nigel Nichols from England, who put out James Trott, Mark Beattie, who beat, I'm trying to think who Mark beat, Alex Clay, defending champion, and Joe Beattie, who beat Alistair McCrane. So we'll just start with the matches here. We'll have a quick look at Joe against Mark, playing on mat 11. Of course, these guys played many times before, and certainly in a couple of ranking event finals. Memorably, the World Masters, I think it was in 2016. Great game between them there. Both were on four titles, and whoever went on to win would get five. So very experienced players. So Mark obviously using the red bowls, Joe using the blue bowls. Do say hello. Let me know where you are. Any questions, let me know, and I'll try to answer them for you. We've had a great weekend of bowls, superb World Cup on Friday, which was won by Ireland, beating Sweden by one shot. Very tense affair that was, and then some brilliant bowls over the weekend, and we're now down to the semi-finals. A slight change from the previous years as Joe gets in there, another second bowl. So one to Mark with one to come. Yeah, there will not be a bronze medal match now at our events. Both the losing semi-finalists will share a bronze medal and share the prize money. And we'll just concentrate on what will be the final. Yeah, great draw for Mark. The players decided not to have a roll-up or a trial end, and you can see they're straight onto it. So two shots to Mark, first end. Two shots, one end. I tell you, Jonas also picked up two shots against Nigel, first end. Still a few people left behind to watch the semi-finals. Hopefully they'll stay for the final. Obviously a lot of people with long journeys, so some have made their way home. But it's great to have you guys along with us. Please feel free to share this video so others can watch. And we'll have a short break following the conclusion of the semi-finals before we bring you live coverage of the UK Open final in approximately 50 minutes, an hour's time. So, good start again from Mark. Joe just looking to adjust his weight. Yeah, he's looking better here. Yeah, good second bowl. Still a chance for Mark though. Tell you, Jonas is looking to be holding probably four shots on the next mat. So, chance for Joe to rest on that bowl or just nudge Mark's shot bowl down. Fantastic effort, just slightly short of pace. So Mark asking who's holding, James tells him it's him. I think it's only one. One bowl left each. So Jonas picked up the second end against Nigel with a single, so leads 3-0 after two ends. Meanwhile, Mark here just looking to drop right back in on the jack for two, which he does. So, I think Joe's going to get just clipped on the short bowl. He is, yeah. Yeah, so it looks like two. Yeah, so two conceded by Joe. Just to confirm the score over there. Jonas 3, Nigel 0. Two ends played. And Mark takes a 4-0 lead after two ends in the semi-final we're concentrating on at the moment. Another good start from Mark, touch and run pass, perfect lead bowl. Good reply from Joe there. Mark may be contemplating playing at this jack. Yeah, he's nominated some weight. Yeah, just missed the line a little bit. Flicks Joe's over. Still shot bowl for Joe. Joe just slightly over pace. Not happy with that. Here again, Mark nominating weight, so. Oh, yeah. Removes the shot pole, which is a toucher, so it'll stay in the ditch. And Mark holds the one. Joe back down to the draw. Yeah, better bait with this bowl. Yeah, very good. Great adjustment. Sits for a touch. So change of hands for Mark. You know, look to come down, just push Joe's away. Yeah, just slightly short of pace. So one to Joe, last bowl of the end to come. Yeah, down on a good line again. Might just run through. No. Yep, used his own bowl, so sits in for two. Actually, just going to switch sides here. So, again, for those of you, well, for those who might be watching with no sound, I'll show them the scoreboard, 4-2. And Nigel took a two on the third end then, so he is 3-2 down to Jonas. Benny Shorgren's... James. So Joe just asking James to change the jack length there. Yes, Benny's currently 3-0 up against Don McNamara in the plate final. And it's 2-1 to Michael Dorey in the shield final against Wendy Ford. Yeah, Mark looks pretty good here. Just wants to run a bit more. So holds a shot, but Joe will be certainly reaching this with a. Yeah, he's playing a good couple of yards. Yeah, touched the block. So James stops it. Just flicked the block. Good ball for Mark, so change angle of that shot, so back to the draw I think for Joe. Down on the forehand. He's on a very good road. Yeah, very good ball. Again, you can see with the weight of this jack, the 32 ounce jack, that sometimes you touch the jack and the ball falls away. You can tell we are currently working on the production of a slightly lighter jack that we feel will work better for the game. So we'll keep you updated on that. Good response from Mark. Joe just asking how many shots it is. I didn't see what James said actually. I don't know if it was two or three. Certainly two. Joe playing a bit of weight, close to the shot bowl. Oh, that's a great bowl. So, two down to two up. And one bowl for Mark to come. Thinks it's a bit tight, might turn it over though. No, not enough. I think it's two, we'll have a quick look. Yeah, favour two there. Yeah, so two it is, two to Joe. So we're back to all square, four all after three ends. Four ends, sorry, yeah. So, four all, four ends played. Touch. Yep. Yeah, Joe trying very hard with this. Gets a touch. Should fall down. Makes it pretty close. Yep, so James is confident that Joe's holding with last ball. Switching to the forehand now. Wants to run a bit more. This looks very close. Oh, unlucky, I think. James just popping in to have a look to see he's holding. Yeah, so for those of you who don't understand Devon, that was, I still like yours, Joe, but it's quite tight. Joe also using the forehand. We'll just like to roll Mark's away. Yeah, weight was good. just under the line. So Mark's going to come and have a look to see if he agrees with James. Another try for Mark. Oh, that's fantastic. Great ball from Mark. Yeah, he might have even moved the chucker fraction for two. Still, you think Joe will look to play probably Mark's front ball onto the jack. Oh, what a ball from Jonas in the background there. Both of Nigel's bowls. I'll tell you the score in that at the moment is 4-2 to Jonas after four ends. We'll just stay on this angle so you can see the jack. Joe's just delivering now. Yeah, a bit of pace on the bowl. Looking to punch a short bowl up. Yeah, again, just pinch the line of fraction. It's Marco's last bowl. I doubt very much he'll be playing it. Apologies for the legs. Had a look. You might feel he can catch his outside bowl here and push Joe through. Might even get a three out of it. It's like dangerous if he's a bit wide and just flicks a shot bowl, it could move the jack across. Yeah, it's just draw weight, really. Yep, so just rest up. Nigel did pick up a single on the end over there, so it's 4-3 to Jonas after five in the second semi final. Umpire's called, so it's certainly one to Mark. So we'll let Ian have a measure of that. Jonas just running the jack in. Nigel with a bowl shorter, that was on a short length as well, that jack. So again, Jonas using vectors, which are straight bowls, so he has been playing a bit of a running game today. See in the plate final there. Don McNamara now 6-3 up against Benny Shawgren after four ends. I can't quite see the score in the Shield final from here, but I'll update you shortly. So back here, looking for the measure. This is, of course, measure for second bowl. Mark already with one. Yeah, I think that's probably. Yep, so it is. It is two. So 6-4 after five ends. On we go. So Mark to lead off on the sixth end. This is the halfway point at the completion of this end. So Joe's coming down the forehand side. It's going to leave this jack high, so see what Mark plays. He's stepping out. Yeah, Mark reaching a couple of yards of pace. Yeah, good contact. Jack's gone dead. Of course, Joe doesn't have a toucher, so decision now will be, I don't think he's got the angle on the forehand to try and half Mark's bowl across towards the camera. So it's whether he'll just look to yeah, no, he is going to play weight. Perhaps you can just see enough of it. Well, he's reversing it actually. Okay, so he has moved it. Yeah, he did. So basically he played down the forehand side but with a backhand bowl to hold the bowl a bit straighter. So he's moved it. He has given himself a chance now to draw the line for shot. Hello Hillary, thanks for joining us. One shot to mark as we stand. And that's number two in. So I think Joe will probably follow that bowl down. Just wants to get inside his own. Yeah, just didn't push across the delivery line there. So the bowl pulled in quickly to the block as he played it slightly inside out. So one bowl left each on this sixth end. Mark line two. Jonas Hager, I can tell you, is 7-3 up after six ends against Nigel in the other semi-final. Michael Dory leads Wendy Ford 5-3 after five ends in the Shield final. Don McNamara still 6-3 up against Buddy Shawgren. So we're back to a forehand strike this time. Yeah, wanted that full really. Has killed the bowl, so two. Hiya Streets, hope you're well mate. So we'll just come up, let's check the scoreboard. Let's see, so 8-4, six ends, four shot lead, halfway stage. We are running slightly behind schedule today. The weather's been very hot, obviously, as it has been in most parts. So even though we've had the aircon on in the centre here, it has been very warm. So players are just struggling a little bit. So we've had a few breaks. And obviously, as I said earlier, for those of you who are watching, we had a slight delay. There's a lot of players who are watching the end of the cricket earlier on, but still. Joe with a good lead bowl, Mark slightly through, but a better adjustment from Mark here. Yeah, very good. Yeah, hi Hillary. You can see James obviously is marking this match. He did just lose in the previous match to Nigel Nichols, who's playing in the second semi-final. He was 9-1 down, but came back to, well, pretty much 9-all, but just lost on the last bowl. So it was a good match, but he has been confirmed as world number one now following his run in this tournament. So some good has come out of the weekend for James. Hi Meredith, yeah, I will pass on your good wishes to Don. As I say, he is up at the moment in the final there on the show map. Close, just wide. I think it's two at the moment to Joe. Perhaps James can confirm for me. It is two, yeah. So Joe just coming up to have a look. Hi Andrew, hi Poms, hope you're well. So, forehand draw for Joe. Third bowl of the end for him. Just going to pinch tight. Yeah. Would have liked to have sat right in that gap there. Mark obviously with best back here, so maybe we'll see him just play a reaching bowl now. This is his last bowl of the end. Four shots up in the match. Well, orthodox stance, so he could be playing either. Yeah, just a yard of pace over. Yeah, bowl's just holding. So two to Joe, he's got to get back in the game. Just wants to come and see how it's lying. He might even be looking at a cheeky shot for four, but I don't think Mark's bowls connect with each other on a good angle, so I would expect Joe probably just to draw this for three. Yeah, the aqua bowls in the back are mint and white coloured Taylor Vectors. Available here in the UK. So Joe running up. He's going to touch a jack, I think. So maybe still only two. I'll just let Mark have a look. Yeah, removes the two. Yeah, so just the two. So 8-6, seven ends. Mark still leads. Nigel, bit of a comeback against Jonas now. 8-7 to Jonas after eight ends. Don McNamara 6-5 against Benny Sjogren. And it is now 6-3 to Wendy in the Shield final. It's quite a way away, so it's difficult to see the scoreboard from here properly. So Joe leading off, long jack. And Mark looking to attack this again, first ball. Just on the wide side, but we'll get the ball. So fair result. Hi Sam, all matches today, 12 ends, so five to go in this game, and the final will also be 12 ends. Joe's turned away from that pretty quick. See why, just drifting across the line again and not really reaching, so regroup for the next ball. Mark following Joe, just getting a bit of turn, but a nice kick inwards there off of Joe's bowl. So again, Joe's just pinched it. Won't be too happy with that. Mark's chance to capitalise now. Get one close. Joe with only one bowl left to play this end. And Mark's going to touch us but just drop through. Now then, will this prove tempting for Joe? Probably three down. Yes it is, so he's playing down with a bit of weight. Needed the jack full, it was the only result he would get. So there's two down, likely to drop a three. Jonas Hager playing some great stuff on the far mat there. So just picked up a three, as has Mark here. Yep, three shots to Mark. No disputing that from Joe. So three ends to play in the second semi-final. As Jonas leads 11-7 after nine ends. A three for Mark here. He's now 11-6 up after eight ends. So as I said earlier, there will be no bronze medal match. As we now allocate a bronze medal to both losing semi-finalists and they split the prize money. So we can concentrate totally on the cup final. It will be the only game playing in the next session. Feedback from the players tended to be that the disappointment of losing the semi-final was a bit of a downer, so they found it hard to get themselves up for a bronze medal match, even with you know, some money involved. So we took the decision to drop the bronze medal match. Yeah, touch from Marks, just short of the jack, I think. Yeah, it's close to shot. Yeah, Joe making sure he's reaching here. Oh, he's got a bit of a wobble on this, so it might just hold it out a fraction. No, he has come back. No, yeah, good bowl. And he has stayed for shot, I can see that from here. So one to Joe. Mark coming up to have a look. Just seen Jonas holding one, but it's just rolled Nigel Nicholls' bowl over onto the jack. So we'll see what happens there shortly. Meanwhile, back here, Mark playing down the backhand side, looking to chip Joe's bowl out of the head. Yeah, he's done exactly that. So back to one on for Mark. Joe will be desperate to win this end. Yeah, playing on that tighter line now. Again, looking for the same result. Does look close. Oh, well, flick the jack. Yeah, it's got a result. Really wanted Mark's bowl, but we'll be happy with the outcome. So Joe, obviously, five shots down. 11-6. So we'll want at least a single and definitely a double. So final bowl of the end for Mark. Yeah, just a draw for Mark. I think this bowl looks a bit short though. Yeah. Mark does tend to have a bit of a wobble on his bowls, which will affect a bit of the pace. So Joe, if he can get a very slight touch on this jack, could make a three here. And he's out on the long stuff. Bowl's coming back nicely. Safe two. Let's see what it is. I think it's only two, is it? We'll see what's given here. Might only be two. One removed, two conceded, but yeah, so just the two. So 11-8 after nine ends, three to play. 11-7 after nine ends in the other semi-final, although the last bowl of the 10th end's just happened, I think. Yes, one to Jonas. So he now leads 12-7, so five shots in it, two ends to play. Jonas looking a favourite to get through to his first SMPT singles final. Nigel, of course, winner of our British Open. So he has one title to his name. So crucial end. Surprised actually Jonas probably didn't go for the jack on this end to try and win the match outright. Yeah, Mark just playing down. Update in the plate final. Benny now leading against Don, 8-7 after seven ends. And Michael 7-4 up against Wendy in the other in the Shield final. Yep, good response from Joe. Mark down the backhand is looking for the jack here. Yep, got it, chipped it across though. So So Jonas has bowled three bowls over on the far mat there. So his lying match. Two bowls left for Nigel Nichols. Oh yeah, great bowl. So, great bowl from Nigel. Holding two, maybe three. Back here, Joe with a fantastic draw to the line. That's certainly one. I'll see if James can see if it's just one, James. Yeah, just one, two. Yeah, so one to Joe, and Mark has got second and third with the two red bowls. Definitely second bowl that one. So one to Joe. Now this is tricky because Mark and Joe just having a joke between them there. Because Joe now knows he's in a bit of trouble. Joe's got to look to get, he's got to get at least third bowl here. So I think two shots have been removed over on the other mat for Nigel, and they're just looking at a third. It's not a bad bowl that from Joe actually. So still holding the shot. Now, of course, if Mark can get a full house four here, that will put him seven shots up with two ends to play. So it's a shot down the backhand for Mark. I think he's going to look for these two blue bowls. Play one onto the other, clear them out. This is literally game if he gets this. Oh, Joe's bowl stayed alive, but I think. Yeah, one there for Mark. Yeah, so one conceded by Joe, so it's one to Mark. I can tell you, Jonas is three shots up now, 12-9. They're playing the last end. Actually, what I'll do is I'll pop back around and we'll just see the conclusion of that match and come back to this one. So I say Jonas three shots up, so Nigel three for at least a draw. If it does end in a tie, then of course a tie break will be played. Just wanted that bowl full, Nigel, really. Just to remind you, Mark is 12-8 up against Joe. Two ends to play. Yeah, good bowl from Jonas. Young man from Sweden looking for his first appearance in a ranking event final here with us. And Nigel forced into trying to disturb this. Oh, yeah, he's moved that away. His bowl has stayed alive. So Jonas just coming through. Hi, Brad. Thanks for joining us, mate. Oh, Joe's nearly killed the jack. Over on this mat, he was two down, has opened it up, got one. So here we go, last bowl from Nigel. Missed the jack. That's it, game over. So Jonas is through to the final. Fantastic result for Jonas Hager there. Great effort by Nigel. We have our first finalist, Jonas Hager from Sweden. Second semi-finalist will be joining us from Ireland, but who will it be? Mark Beattie or Joe Beattie? Joe now laying two shots here. Well, I say two. One, James just looking to confirm. Oh, just one it is. So, I'm not going to move from this position because I'm close to being in Mark's eye line. So he is just playing a bit of weight for this jack. It's right on the edge of the mat. Here he comes now. Oh, so he's chipped Joe's bowl out, which was shot. Bit of excitement from the crowd. That'll be those noisy Norwegians who've had a shandy or two, I'm sure. So back to Joe, needs to draw a shot, really. If he fails to do so, Mark's in the final, and he is in. So he will take it to the last end. So, similar situation to the other semi-final. 12-9 to Mark, so Joe needs 3 to tie. Don McNamara now 11-8 up against Benny Shawgren. They're playing the 10th end. And it's now 9-7 to Wendy Ford against Michael Dory in the Shield final. They're playing the 11th end. So back here, second semi-final about to come to a conclusion. Final end now. And Joe Beattie needing a 3 or a 4. Yeah, quite possibly, Alan. Obviously, Jonas beating Joel earlier by a cricket score, really. So, yeah, good start for Joe here. Hope you're all enjoying the coverage. Give us a thumbs up if you are. Hopefully my throat will last out for the final. I'm sure it will. So Joe, good start. Hiding the jack a bit with that bowl. So Mark will just look to draw down now. Yeah. Yeah, it's a fair bowl for Mark. They will drop him for second. So James confirming it is just a 1-2 Joe. That's probably not good. I think that's really stuffed Joe now, that shot. He's gonna have to play some kind of good bowl to get a 3 out of this. Mark, of course, will have another bowl following that. So Mark just looks to draw around in the short. Joe will be kicking himself for that third bowl. Joe does have the option, obviously, of killing the end, so he could play a front bowl onto the jack to kill it. So here we go. A tut, I think he's wide. He is. So it's one shot to Joe, but Mark takes the match. 12-10. Congratulations to Mark. If you want to leave your congratulations for Mark on the feed, I'll stay live for a few minutes. Commiserations to Joe. Good effort, but we will have an Ireland-Sweden final, as we did in the World Cup on Friday, and it will be Mark Beattie versus Jonas Hager. We'll just stay a while longer, so if you watch the conclusion of the plate final. So what we'll do is, when this matches are finished, we'll be off air for 10 minutes or so, just give the players a short break, and then we'll come back to you with live coverage of the final. And we will stay with it afterwards to do the presentations. Gives you a chance to congratulate the winner. So, of course, here you've got Benny Sjogren playing in the plate final, our Norwegian Open champion from last season, against a very experienced and World Cup player, Don McNamara from Ireland. Score currently, if you can see it up there, is 11 shots all. This is now the 11th end. It is close in the Shield final as well. They've got one more end to play. Yeah, good bowl from Benny there. I think it's still one to Don though. Just go and have a wander up so we can see the head of it closely while we wait for Don to bowl. He's going to come and have a look at the head. I could tell you now that in the Shield final it's now 9-all and they're playing the last end. Back here. Close for shot. Maybe just Don's. See the score there. We have removed the boarding from around the show mat so the players and the spectators sitting behind, because obviously we have to have the show mat running away from them so they can get a better view of the mat. Yeah, great bowl from Don there. So this is Benny's last bowl now of the 11th end. Yeah, Benny looking closer here. Just unlucky. I think Don's going to be holding there. Yeah, so it is one to Don, with one bowl to come from him. Line, it does come back from there. All on the weight. Yeah, great bowl, Dom. Very good. Yep, two conceded by Benny. So that does give Don a two-shot lead as we head into the final end. I'll just show scoreboard. There we are, 13-11 after 11 ends. It looks like Wendy's holding two over on the Shield final mat. Michael just about to play his last bowl. I'll just stay with that shot. I know it's a way away, but I'll give you an update. Michael Dory's killed it with his last bowl. So they'll replay the end. So we'll come back to that in a bit. That was a great bowl. I think he was actually going to be holding shot if it didn't fall off, but would have given Wendy plenty of room to draw. So back here in the plate final. Final end. Don up by two. Slightly short with his first bowl. Yeah, Benny on a good line. Just wants to hurry a little bit. Yeah, very good bowl. As I said earlier, again, if this match ends in a tie, we'll play a three-end tie break. Yep, Don's certainly reaching this time. Oh, just misses the jack. So now then, chance for Benny to get one very close, put the pressure on Don. Yeah, that is in for second bowl. Still a bit of a distance there, so Don will look to adjust his weight. Just dropping on Benny's bowl at the back, sits for second shot. Don not happy with this. Although, I'm not sure why, because it's a good bowl. I don't think he liked it. Maybe he thought he chucked it a bit wide, but I'm guessing Don's playing with lignoids. Yes, he is. Ooh. Sorry, camera just rotating on its stand there. So. Oh, lucky for Benny there. Just pushed down. So one bowl left each. Oh, Wendy's just played last bowl. So they've played three bowls each in the Shield final. Michael's holding one shot, one bowl left each to come. Jack is in the ditch in the Shield final, so it is a draw to the line for the two guys there. So, yeah, good bowl for Michael Dory. He's left it about 6 inches short of the ditch, so Wendy's going to have to play a great bowl. Don coming in. Well, yeah, so a little bit short, but he's sat in the draw line now. I mean, it's possible that Benny could draw around that. He'd have to just scrape around that last bowl. He does have a draw on the other hand too, which might be an easier option to sit on Don's bowl. I'll just flick to Wendy's bowl over there. She's looking to draw or push in off by the looks of it. Will it stop? Oh, just gone in the ditch. So Michael Dory takes the Shield final, 10-9. And the last bowl of the match now for Benny, needing 2 to tie. He stepped out, so I guess he's playing touch of white, tight. No, not enough. 1 to Benny, so Don McNamara takes the plate final by 13 shots to 12. Another very good game. So, ladies and gents, we'll break it there now for 10 minutes or so while we prep for the UK Open final between Mark Beattie and Jonas Hager. Keep an eye on our Facebook page. We'll be up on there shortly live to bring you that final. Please join us and share the match. And we look forward to seeing you shortly. Thanks very much for joining us. Thank you.